Hey everybody, welcome to another Divi Engine tutorial where we're going to discuss something that has been blowing up lately, and of course we're talking about AI. Now, what we're going to be looking at today is vibe coding, what it is, and how to use it in your Divi workflow to even maybe create little plugins and stuff like that for quality of life upgrades to your Divi flow. Now, AI obviously has been exploding lately, and vibe coding is a term that you might know or not know. So let me first explain what vibe coding is, and this is something that you cannot ignore. Vibe coding basically means that you are creating software or code with the assistance of an LLM or an AI tool like ChatGPT. Now, this doesn't mean that you need to be some coding genius to use it. There are people that don't know code that are using this to either augment, add, or extend the software that you're using now, or building simple websites to plugins to all sorts of stuff. And it has even gone a step further now where there are these agents within tools like Cursor and Windsurf, which we'll be looking at today, where this is baked into a coding environment called the IDE, which basically is where the code lives. And you have this AI tool integrated so it understands the context of the files and all the different things as it relates to what you're trying to do. So now that we kind of have a basis of what vibe coding is, let's get into today's tutorial. All right, so here we go. I told you guys we're going to be building or vibe coding a Divi plugin, and that's exactly what we're going to do right now. So what do we want to build? I thought let's take and extend a very common module in the Divi theme, the Divi contact module, which we also have a module for the Divi form builder, but we can get into that later. So one of the main features that people gripe about not being, you know, available in the Divi contact module is the ability to save the database. And very often you're going to need another plugin to do that. So let's vibe code our way into some DB bliss. And of course, like I mentioned before, we're going to be utilizing a tool called Windsurf. And that is this guy right here, where you can actually use it for free. Right now, they are giving you the ability to use some pretty advanced models for free for a limited time, which is obviously very cool. And yeah, it is an IDE with AI at its core, and it will even give you context of the files that you have. So here is the interface for Windsurf, and you can see that I've kind of played around here a bit. But the first thing you're going to do, and let me just close my folder, is you're either going to open a folder or you're just going to jump right in and start coding with Cascade, which is the AI agent in Windsurf. Now, if you don't want to use Windsurf, you can use something like Cursor, same difference. But I'm going to jump in here into one of my Divi installs that I got. And this is just a plain sight. So here is just the dashboard. We can see here, if I go to the plugins, no funny business, just WooCommerce basically and some other dummy data plugins. And then I've just got a normal form here. And if we submit that, we will see that it does nothing really. It just sends the email, right? Just like the regular Divi contact form. Okay, so we want to extend this to show the entries in the database. We're probably going to want a menu item here on the left-hand side to be able to review those entries and then manage them, of course. So here's what we're going to do. I'm going to take you here into Windsurf, and let's just quickly explore this a little bit. Right up here, you can go ahead and you can select the model that you're using. And as you can see, GPT-4.1 is free right now. And it's got two modes. It's got write and chat. Chat is when you want to have a conversation about your code. And write is when you wanted to actually go ahead and write the code for you. Now, you can see I have my project folder open here. It's a local site. But again, you don't need this. It just gives it better context of what you're trying to do. And then it just comes down to telling it what you want. Now, it's good to be detailed here because, you know, it's going to only be as good as what you give it. There's the trope in AI, garbage in, garbage out, and that really counts here too. Now, I have a prepared prompt that I just pasted in here, which this basically gets into it. Create a plugin for the Divi theme that saves form entries from the Divi contact module to the database. And then I tell it what it must be doing. Must intercept and store Divi contact form submissions, including all the fields with the labels and the values, into a custom and unique database table. Create a custom admin menu item called Divi form submissions with a paginated list of stored entries And then each entry should show the form title, date, time, and the IP address. Now the user should be able to click on any of the form entries to see the details. And then the WordPress coding standards and non-SQL secure form handling should be followed. You want to make sure that it's secure. And then lastly, we want to make provision for sufficient error handling. And that's it. So let's see what happens when I hit the enter key and bust through. And you can kind of see how it like rationalizes what it's thinking about. You'll be familiar with this if you use the reasoning models. And then it even knows where the directory is, where the plugin is supposed to be going, which is crazy. Yeah. And then it just decides also, well, it's going to create this database table. It's going to create the admin menu, the security, and the error handling. So let's see what it does here. And it talks you through every step of the process, which is really cool. You know, it kind of feels like you live in the future here. Now, also, you know, I mentioned this in the beginning. It's just not necessarily a replacement for coders because, you know, a lot of times the debugging can only go that far. But it certainly is a nice step for people to help customize on a basic level some of the things they're trying to do in Divi, in WordPress, or in anything. You can see here that there was an error in creating the file. That sometimes happens. And what my guess is it's going to come up with a request to a terminal command. I can even open up my plugins folder here. You can see that it has not created anything yet. It's doing its thinking thing. Okay, you see that it kind of failed a few times. So it's asking me, can it run a terminal command? And that's also cool that it can actually do that. But now we can see that the plugin name kind of appeared right over there, the VForm submissions. And now it is attempting to create. So I guess the issue there was is that the folder wasn't being able to create itself here from the actual IDE. But yeah, there you go. Now, when it spits out code, it's going to ask you to accept changes. So, you know, for the more advanced people out there, they can look at it and be like, ah, that doesn't make sense to me. But we're going to accept it because I ain't no coder. Cool. So now it says, okay, here's what it's done. Intercepts everything, creates all that fun stuff. And then on the next steps, you have to go and activate the plugin and then submit a new form and give it a go. So why don't we just go do that? We're going to go onto our site. We're going to go to the plugin settings. And there we can see our plugin placed right there. So we can activate it. Activate it just fine. That's usually a good sign. Now we can refresh this page and it should show the menu item. The VForm submissions right there. If I click on that, of course, there's nothing in there yet because we haven't submitted a form. Okay, so let's get our form up again. And we're going to just say Roby at test.com and dummy data. Okay, submit. Okay, nothing crashed so far. Now, hopefully if I refresh this, our form entry is there. How awesome is that? Now we can click through. Now this ain't pretty, so we're gonna wanna do something about that, but that's not too bad for a start, right? So I'm gonna go and do this and I'm gonna take a screenshot of what the submission details look like and I'm gonna save this. I'm gonna show you something else. So I'm gonna just hit back to list again here. I'll open up Windsurf, and now I'm going to go and open up image, and you can see I added my image in there. I'm going to say that worked great, but the detail page is very ugly and does not show the details such as the form fields and their values, because that's obviously very important to us. So let's see what it does with that information. Now, also a lot of times, you know, I need to mention that you get instant gratification almost every single time, but then it takes a little bit of massaging to get it where you need to go. So that's where the vibe part comes from. It's a little bit of back and forth between you and the AI tool. Doesn't make it bad because it certainly to put all this together would take me hours of watching YouTube tutorials and stuff like that. And you're, it's just kind of doing its thing almost instantaneously. And there you go. It's got some, you know, suggestions here to add and remove stuff. I'll just accept all. And now it says that page should be improved. So let's test it. So let's refresh this really quickly and then click on view. And that's a bit better, but you know, it kind of drops the WordPress styling. So I'm gonna go ahead and it also didn't show us all the form fields. Okay, so back to Windsurf. And now we tell it, I want the detail screen to remain in the WordPress dashboard and not on a separate page that loses the WordPress sidebar and admin bar. You need to be very specific sometimes. So I'm going to say that. Now, the other thing is a big issue is that the detail screen still shows no detail. No form fields are present. Let's see what that does. Now we're going to go ahead and accept that change that it asked me to do. Accept all the changes. And let's go see what that does. Let's refresh this page, of course, and then click through. And there we go. Now we're actually in a better spot, but it's saying no form fields found. Let me just, for argument's sake, try and submit this again. I will just say Bob and Bob at bob.com and blah, blah, blah. Okay. So let's continue on here. Okay. Thanks for contacting us. Let's go back to the list. The new entry should be there. Click on that one. No form fields found. Let's just click on the other one really quickly. No form fields found. Okay, that's problematic. So let's just quickly read what they told us to do again. So the next steps, we should be seeing all the details. That's basically what they're telling us. Okay, so let's tell it there seems to be an issue capturing the submitted fields from the form. You need to make sure to capture all the fields and their values. You also need to make sure you capture the form title correctly, because I saw that just still said contact form. So let's go ahead and try that. Okay, so here we go. It made a bunch of changes. You can review them if you want. And then I'm just going to go ahead and accept them blindly. Now, I do want to point out one more thing. Like, you are free to go edit this code if you'd like. I can go ahead and say Divi Engine is the author of this plugin if I wanted to. And then I just got to remember to save it. And now it says, okay, submit a new entry, view the details in the dashboard. I'm going to do one extra precautionary step here, and I'm going to actually go to plugins. I'm going to deactivate the plugin and then reactivate it. Sometimes it does some actions when you activate the plugin. So when I count for that, now if I come back here, got all that stuff, and you know, these ones are still saying no form fields found. So let's try and submitting a new form. And we can just go with whatever at this point, because it's not saving nothing anyway. So let's see if that works better. Now, like I said, this is a massaging process they need to do, and it's still capturing the naming correctly. But let's click on view here. Okay, let's click on view. Let's go. Okay, and no captured fields. So the journey continues. Let's take a screenshot, and actually maybe let me just do that a little bit tighter and show what it's doing. So I'm going to save that again. We'll go back to Windsurf and I'll tell it, okay, well, you're going to look at this image, and then we'll just say no fields are being captured. You need to verify whether you are using the correct parameters. I don't know. The form title is also not capturing, right? The form title or name is also just Divi contact form instead of the title that I set. Let's see what that does. And let me just check my sanity here. Divi contact form. Yeah, that's what it's saying the form title is. But we know that it's this one, the vibe code. So let's see what it spits out. You know, and depending on how long this goes on, it might be well worth the $10 or whatever you would spend on a plugin that does this. I know there's one or two on the Divi marketplace. But, you know, it's definitely a good learning tool. And, you know, obviously what I'm doing is a little bit more complex than, you know, smaller things that one could do. But yeah, it certainly is fun to kind of poke around and see what we can do. I just accepted those changes. It's still thinking here. It says the entry fields, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let's see what it does now. So let's go back to our form. Let's go to the submissions. This I don't expect to be any different, but let's submit a brand new form and see what happens. And we'll go with the same old, and do that. Okay, let's refresh. Still the wrong title. That might be something I have to give up. Okay, now we're getting somewhere, right? Now we've got all the stuff in a JSON format. All I'm going to do now is just take one more screenshot here and say, okay, we made progress, but fix it. Almost there. Make the field data show nice. That is terrible language there, but I think the LLM will understand. I'm pretty surprised that, you know, GPT-4.1 is having a harder time at this, because it's supposedly the top model from OpenAI for coding right now. I don't know if maybe we use one of those reasoning models, and I'm just accepting there again, if that would make a difference. But of course, I'm on the free plan right now. So maybe Claude will do better. I'm not sure. But the free plan does come with 50 prompts per month, I believe it is. So we could give that a go if there's still struggles, but let's see. It's made the changes. Let's hop on here. Let's refresh this. And there we go. It is displaying exactly how we want it to, except for the form title. For some reason, that's not pulling in. I'm going to give up that fight right now because I want to show you guys how to extend this a little bit further still. So I'm going to go ahead and I would like to be able to delete them and I would like to be able to export them. So let's just go back to Windsurf real quick and I'll say, great. I will mention the form title though. The form title is still wrong, but it works otherwise. Please, I don't know why I'm nice to the robot, but maybe he's my boss one day. So please add the ability to delete entries as well as export them. Let's see. I mean, we've made some pretty good progress here though. I'm pretty happy with the result thus far, depending on your use case, you know, of course, and your knowledge level. My knowledge level is close to zero. So, you know, like I said in the beginning of the video, your mileage might vary. But yeah, not too bad. Now, I haven't really tried doing any type of visual things, but I would imagine that you can include different libraries like Particle.js and other fun stuff to go ahead and extend the visual capabilities of Divi. You know, as we wait for Divi 5, of course, it's fun to tinker with these things and play around. But yeah, okay, there we go. Okay, the code is there. Let's apply the changes. It's going to tell me what to do. I can delete, I can export. And they improved the form title extraction. Let's see whether that actually does do anything. So we'll just refresh this page. Okay, so now I can delete. Delete, confirmation, love it. And there you go, it's gone. Over here, I can even delete it from here. That's awesome. And it actually redirects to the top level page. Now, for interest sake, I'm going to go ahead and just enter one more entry. And then we'll call it a day. And we'll just say test me. And we'll say test at me.com. And this is a test. And submit. And there we go. And then let's refresh. Form title, still wrong. It can't hack it. But that's fine. Yeah, and there you have it, guys. We just vibe coded our very own Divi plugin that fulfills partially the functionality of some paid plugins out there. Of course, with a little bit more nurturing, a little bit more time, we can make it work the way that we want it to, but we don't have time for that. One thing that I want to mention is that some of the other things that you might want to do to take it further, of course, is to go ahead and give it different ways to export data. Maybe you want to be able to bulk delete data, you know, all sorts of things. Maybe you want to edit entries. I don't know. But there are a lot of different things that you can do to extend this type of thing. And I'm pretty excited to see where this stuff goes in the future. But does it make Divi Engine and other, you know, guys like PA obsolete? No, of course not. Because, you know, it takes a lot more than just a little bit of AI magic to build the tools that we do. But this is a great way for you to be self-sufficient. You can even go ahead and debug stuff that you might be experiencing on your site. And I experiment a bit with adding code directly to the functions.php. So you don't always need to have a plugin necessarily. It depends on your use case and what you're trying to do. But that is vibe coding a Divi plugin with Windsurf. And it's been a pleasure. I hope you guys enjoy this. Please like and subscribe the video and comment, because I can try out some other stuff. For numpty like I can do this, so can you. So guys, it's been Robbie with the Divi Engine team. Thank you for being here, and I'll catch you in the next one real soon. Bye for now.